Okay, everybody, so we saved the best for last, Ms. Vang An Tan. She's from San Jose. She's going to talk to us about youth leadership, charity, and peace for the Cham community. Please welcome her.
Assalamualaikum. Lạ đông khăn luôn hả? Lạ sẽ đăng cho Nan Pi cái lạ bó rõ cái slide của lạ với hải. Ok, lạ sẽ đâm chăm, lạ sẽ đâm English với, tại vì lạ có thể đâm qua bọn mấy. Ca tôi bản lạ tăng English kia. So, lạ ngăn là Văn Anh, lồn mấy đều thao lạ ngăn Văn Anh, lạ hụt ngăn cho vợ là Jasmine. Lạ đã thành lập hội này ní là cách ní hợp anh thôi ní chờ. Lạ ngã bắt đầu start là cho chăm lây lạ, and cho Campuchia. Tân hiện nhận ní là lạ đã nào khắp những lây chăm tỏ cho nên thuận lão phân biệt chăm chú, chăm ni hay chăm và hay chăm estamo chăm hay là đều giúp hay giúp cả biết nên thuận lây tí lây ni lây nam lây u lây chẳng là đã tôi hỏi là đã từng nào đó là ưu tiên giúp đỡ lớn nhất là những nữ nét mồ côi hu mẹ hu mơ ô hu a hu khăn chú nào bài ô hu sát hu vợ ô là support So I'm gonna be speaking English for my friends that could not understand Cham. I am the founder of Moonlight Humanity Foundation in 2010, so it's been almost 8 years now. What I focus on education for the orphans, for disabled, women empowerment, and clean water. I started out in my village and then the Cambodia where my uncle was working on. And then from then on, I spread all over the Cham Nen Thuong area. And then I'm going on Southeast Asia. My mission is to help the Cham people, the indigenous minority groups, regardless of race, color, religion, background. We support everyone. So whatever everyone is talking today about the Mayar, Rade, Raglai, even the Rohingya, the Moonlight Humanity have already support them all. Thank God. So, why did I name it Moonlight Humanity? Because I grew up in a village we didn't have electricity. I grew up in a village where there was the moon. It shined to all humanity. It gave light, hope, mercy, blessing, and guidance. That's what it means to me. So I want to bring that beauty of Moonlight Humanity to all mankind and to the world. So that's me back in two years ago. In my village, this is the orphans without mother or father. We all give them education and also monthly rice every month, 10 kilograms of rice. This is back in 2011, so we support winter for jacket, whatever their needs. So we don't have much. As you know, our Cham community is very small, and I'm the only one here in San Jose that doing this kind of work. So we don't have much fun, so we do the best we could to get. What I do is I leverage with other community, like the Arab, how we connect with them is because we are Muslim. That's why I get a lot of support from that group of people. So once your community cannot support you, you as a leader, as a Cham youth, whatever you are a minority group, you have to go outside of your box, connect with a bigger group that are willing to support you and help you. That way you can grow and you can get bigger. And I never know I am what I am today. I have actually raised almost $100,000 now, and we have support almost 1,000 orphans around the world. Thank you. So this is the Cham, you know. As you can see, you cannot tell if they are Muslim, non-Muslim. It doesn't matter. As long as they are poor, they need help, we help them. And these are the groups of the Cham in Cambodia that I found. And the groups of Cham in Vietnam that are leaders that are willing to go with me to support people that are in need. And on our journey, like the car was broken, you know, it was, but we still keep going. This is the house, particular house in the Cham village in Cambodia that you would see. They still have this cow house. In Cham language, we call it Thang Lang. Back in the old day, when I was young, in my village, we have this type of house. No, in my village, we no longer have this kind of house. But in Cambodia, you see 99% have this type of house. So they have a lot of needs. That's why today we are Moonlight Humanity, we are helping about over 200 kids that are learning English every single day. Because in Cambodia, they have more needs. So I'm actually focusing to help more in Cambodia in terms of education. So I brought the doctor with me, and each day we've seen about 100 patients and 100 of students. We taught them dental hygiene. Why I'm showing you this is because we put out the sign language to see if they can see it, and none of them can read. Even if we put it down, the Cambodian language, they cannot read. So the Cham in Cambodia, they do not know how to read. So like 95% of them are not educated. They cannot go to school. They cannot go to elementary school. They cannot go to high school because of poverty and because of lack of education and because of the genocide from the Khmer Rouge. And that go back to the history, and that go back to our panelists that have talked earlier this morning. So we, as a younger generation, we need to help. And so this is the leader groups. They were all there to help me to make it happen. And they are learning the English right now. And so we don't have a school. What we do is we integrate it inside the home and we make it into a classroom. So the cost is very. And we also give them food daily, like snack. We also make dua for donors. Whoever have a special needs, they can tell us, we can make dua for them every day. So like one of the sheikh, he got cancer. He was our board member. So I asked the child to make dua for them. You know, if any one of you know Sheikh Aladdin, he's our board member and he's our partner. He was supposed to go on a journey with me this year to Cambodia, but unfortunately he cannot, so we're making dua for him. These are the people in Burma, the Rohingya people. So we're talking about the Rohingya genocide. We want to help the minority group in Southeast Asia, and we build water well for the Burma Muslim as well. And this is the Burma Muslim. This woman, she was a single mom. She didn't have a home. She didn't have a job. We supported her with $400 loan, and now she became so famous. She got the news international. People came to her, and I told her if she helps everyone in her village turn that into school and teach other people, then she doesn't have to pay us back. So she did that, and she doesn't have to pay us back. See, that's her classroom. They built it themselves. We just 3 weeks ago, we did a fashion show. It's called Women Empowerment and Fashion Show. And so we got gathered with groups of women in Bay Area, and we are doing the performing dance, butterflies, and the moon. And that's me. I just started this fashion because I felt like we have need of, you know, modesty fashion and as business entrepreneur as well. And I'm doing this, and percentage is going back to Moonlight Humanity. One of, you know, like as I mentioned, our Cham people are a minority group, and we have a lot of needs. And we cannot look inside our box only. We have to go further. We have to connect with other people. And I have a lot of connection with doctors, scholars, PhD. They always come and to ask me, what do you need? We are here to help you. So whenever I need help, I just call them up. They are the first ones that help me, besides the Cham people. I drew an event in June. Over 200 people came. It was free dinner, but I was able to raise more than $5,000 that night. And later on, another like $30,000, like in June. So this is my last slide. This is on my business card. I have it outside for everyone who interested to know more about us. You can take it on your way out. This is the magnet, so you can remember and donate. It's only $10 a month for the orphans. It's, you know, so please support. This is the first time I'm asking Chum community $10 a month. Thank you. Okay, Cao Quỳnh, sorry, hạt đó Mỹ biết luôn là không đơn trăm mô. Có nghĩa là ăn là đã tự thành lập cái hội ni từ năm 2010 là chủ yếu là giúp đỡ nữ nét mồ côi, hông dân ha, hông nữ mây hư hư biểu ngã ô là giúp đỡ nhau biết cái nhau hư biểu ngã. Lúc đầu là lại giúp đỡ trong lây ngoài là hông cho Campuchia tên tài nó là nào khắp cho nên thuận. Hôm nay tí, hôm nay tố, hôm nay đang những nay thật thật lâu lão phân biệt đạo và đạo nì, đạo Islam thấy thật nhất là chăm chày, chăm miệng là chăm tội giờ là đều do biết luôn. Đó là hội của Lạp, là hội của Lạp đa số là những nước Muslim của bản hạ giúp đỡ chăm chày. Hạ Cao Vinh nói, thank you.
Yani chương trình Harai Ni hội đại hội là bây giờ Yani tổ Mỹ và tổ vợ cái sang giữa clip của ban tổ chức ngã cho tổ Mỹ và giữa tổ trăm đầy tổ ba lây mai tổ ba lây mai tổng hợp clip nên trang tốt phụng thầy mới thì đấy, tổ ban tổ chức sẽ tổng kết bữa pi từ kể mai tới mấy hai ni cho tổ Mỹ và nên.
Thank you to everyone who hung in there and stuck it out with us for the 2017 Champa Conference. Let's get a big round of applause for all of our speakers and organizers and everybody that came. We've had so many inspiring speakers today that traveled all over, and I just want to say really appreciate all of them for coming in and appreciate the organizers for putting this great event together. Before we end the conference, we have a 10-minute video that the organizers put together for you to enjoy while they have a discussion. So please enjoy, and we'll be right back.
Con Kha thông Mỹ Hoa vợ là chạy tổ chương trình văn nghệ vợ nhận dấu blog lại video cho nên Mỹ Hoa lại nó thang là blog hơi cao mới tỏ dự là tổ nữ cho để ai tổ mia ôn vì hay ni vợ cầu Kha thông Mỹ Hoa do nên
nạ chăm roi chính tức nạ chăm tổ bút phu yên blog bình định màu chế cơ tổ là phụt vào răng bây giờ màu cả màu roi màu oi nên nhớ bình vô nạ chăm panal blog panal chăm